My biggest fear is the genocide that can take place on the Indian side of Kashmir.
Of which we have no evidence as yet.
Well, open up. Open up. You are here. Did anybody stop you? You went to the LOC, you met people, you're interviewing people. Will they allow you there? Why don't you attempt and try, after having been here, go and make a request to the Indian side and let them allow you to go to Srinagar to meet the leadership over there. Will they allow you? I doubt it. So we have nothing to fear, we have nothing to hide.
Is that your concern, that these two nuclear armed neighbors could go to war, because you would be essentially on the front lines if that happens?
That anything can happen. There can be miscalculations, but before miscalculations, India has taken escalatory steps. In February this year, Indian Prime Minister had threatened Pakistan with the use of nuclear weapons. And at that time, we had said that he doesn't know what he's talking about. But if he takes that step, then that would mean a nuclear Armageddon. And a nuclear winter, not just for South Asia, but for the entire world.
The attack on press freedoms in occupied Kashmir, I wish I was speaking from a moral ground, a moral high ground. And I would be speaking from a moral high ground if my own government was not restricting some human rights and media freedoms in Pakistan. But having said that, we can't equate our concerns about the curtailment of democracy in Pakistan with the military occupation by an extremist Hindutva government, by the man seen as the butcher of Gujarat.